गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू लेसन, अ हीरो. ओके, ऑल ऑफ यू सी व्हाट इज रिटन इन द बॉक्स. फॉर्च्यून फेवर्स द ब्रेव. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय फॉर्च्यून? फॉर्च्यून मीन्स आवर फेट. फेवर्स द ब्रेव, दैट मीन्स दोज हु आर ब्रेव, दोज हु ट्राई टू डू समथिंग, दोज हु ट्राई टू अचीव समथिंग. सो आवर फेट ऑल्सो हेल्प अस टू रीच आवर गोल. Simply, if you sit at one place and you say that I want this or that, will you get it? No. We have to work hard for it, or we have to do some work for it, then only we are going to get something for us. Right, children? Today also we are going to study about a boy named Swami children. He was very introvert, or what we say, he was very coward. He was not at all brave. So his father want him to be brave. So one day, while his father was sitting under the hall lamp and reading the newspaper, he looked over the newspaper and said, "Swami, listen to this. News has been received about the bravery of a village lad." Lad means boy. What is the meaning of lad? Boy. Who was returning home by the jungle path. Okay? So what father did? Father was sitting under the hall lamp and reading the newspaper. Underlined reading and newspaper. And he said to Swami about the bravery of a village lad. Underlined bravery. What a big thing he has done. Lad means boy. Who was returning home by the jungle path. So while the boy was returning, in the middle of the jungle, he came face to face with a tiger. What happened? The boy came face to face with a tiger. The newspaper gave a detailed account of boy's fight with the tiger. So complete story. You all know in newspaper how it comes. A complete story of the boy, how he has faced the tiger has come. How it was described. See, first underline detailed an account. Detailed an account. It also described how the boy flew up a tree where he stayed half a day. So what did the boy do? As soon as he got face to face with the tiger, he climbed a tree. Okay, he climbed a tree. And there he stayed for half a day. At last, some people came that way and killed the tiger. So finally what happened? Some people, some villagers came that side and they killed the tiger. Okay? After reading it through, father looked at Swami fixedly and asked. Now after reading, now father was looking at Swami and he thought that Swami also should do something brave. So what did he ask him to do? Underline fixedly and thought. Through and fixedly. What do you say to that? I think he must have been a very strong and grown-up person, not a boy at all, said Swami. How could a boy fight a tiger? So now he started thinking, I think he must have been a very strong and grown-up boy, not a boy at all, said Swami. Now Swami was thinking that he is not a boy. Okay, how could a boy fight a tiger, he thought. Yes, then you think you know better than the newspaper, father said crossly. A man may have the strength of an elephant and yet be a coward. So what, father started scolding him and said roughly to him that you think you are better than the newspaper and you know better than newspaper. A man may have a strength of an elephant, but he may be a coward. Coward means darfuk. Another may be mere skeleton, but if he has real courage, he can do anything. So another person may be just a skeleton. That means he may not look strong, but from inside he may be very, very brave. He may have courage. Underline courage, children, all of you. Skeleton, courage. Courage is everything. Strength and age don't matter much. How can that be? Said Swami. Suppose I had a lot of courage, but what could I do if a tiger attacked me? Now Swami said, if I have lot of courage, but a tiger attacks me, what should I do? Like that he asked his father. Then, can you prove you have courage? Said father with a scowl. Okay, now father said, you have to prove you have courage. Let me see if you can sleep alone tonight in my office room. So father wants Swami to sleep in his office room alone. Swami had always slept beside his granny in the porch. Porch means, see, when we have a building, the front wall of a window, under it will be there. So said father with this call, let me see if you can sleep alone tonight in my office room, but always Swami used to sit with his grandmother. The two always had their beds side by side. Any change in this arrangement kept him trembling and awake all night. Trembling means shivering, fear. Shivering, fear. Underline, shivering, trembling, sorry, trembling, arrangement. So always he want to sleep with his granny. He doesn't want to sleep alone, but father is asking him to sleep alone. He hoped at first that father was only joking. He thought father was joking. Underline joking. He tried to change the topic by saying, "Father, our captain says we shall have some elders also in our cricket club. He asked me to tell you. We will see about that later." Father cut in, "Hereafter you must sleep alone." So now what happened? Now Swami was afraid that he has to sleep alone. So he wanted to change the topic and he said to father, "Our captain says that we must have elders in our club, father, cricket club," he said. The father said, "Now don't change the topic. Everything we will talk later on. But you have to sleep alone." Underline alone. "From the first of next month, I will sleep alone." So another answer he gave. "From the first of next month, I am going to sleep alone." Swami said very humbly, trying to please his father, "No, you must do it right from today." Father said sternly, "Sleeping beside granny or mother like a baby is disgraceful." So he said, "No. Today you have to sleep alone. Sleeping beside your granny and mother is very disgraceful. It is not good. You are grown up." Underline disgraceful. "You are now in the fifth standard and I don't like the way you are being brought up." So he said, "Now right now you are 10 years old. You are fifth class boy. You should be brave. I am not happy with the way you are being brought up." Father said to Swami. Okay, then father lifted the newspaper to his face and started reading it again. Swami rose quietly, rose is past tense of rise, quietly from his place and tiptoed to his bed in the porch. Granny was sitting up in her bed and she said, "Boy, are you already feeling sleepy today? Don't you want to hear a story?" Now what happened, Swami? What did he do? Father started reading newspaper again. So what did he do? He slowly went near his bed and was pretending to sleep. Now grandmother was calling him, "Are you really feeling sleepy? And you don't want to listen any story?" But why Swami has gone there? Because he doesn't want to sleep alone. So he went and he was just pretending to sleep. See, Swami made no reply. He threw himself on the bed and pulled the blanket over his face. So he has just kept the blanket over his face and was pretending that he was sleeping. So now children, you are going to read the lesson till where it is over. Tomorrow we will see whether Swami slept alone or no. Underline hard words you have to write and learn, and also read the lesson where it has completed. Thank you.